Oh, I love
Nick,
that because.
you can't just say that you have a conspiracy theory and not tell us. So you
All
gotta
right,
tell
fine. If we're
us.
gonna do this, here we go. I was gonna save this for you better you bet today, but here we go. Hold on, hold on. All right. If we have any conspiracy
Oh
theory
my
music, we can
God.
pop this on real quick. So here's the deal. There's already early reports about this being considered. Nobody's been talking about the fact that LeBron James can sign an extension with the Lakers starting, this summer, and it hasn't been discussed. And he's talked about how he wants to play with his son Bronny. So here's what it is. It sounded crazy years ago when we look at LeBron James playing for the Miami Heat, and then they lost in the finals in 2014, and then you started getting reports of, hey, LeBron James is going to go back to Cleveland. I remember I was doing DC radio then, and Chris Sheridan came on. Great NBA reporter came on, and he was the first person to say he's going back to Cleveland. I was like, what are you talking about? No way. He went back to Cleveland. Well, what's happened again? Now, the Lakers are old. The Lakers are aging, just like the Heat got old, and the Heat were aging, just like the Cavs last time around were old. They aged out. They got swept in the finals of the Warriors. What does LeBron do? Well, he jumps ship. LeBron James goes to the next young team. He goes back to Cleveland when they've been gutted. They're a smoldering crater after he leaves. They're terrible. They lose games. They get all this young talent. And then LeBron James goes and plays with the newly rebuilt Cleveland Cavaliers. He did it before. He could absolutely do it again. By the way, I love the Cavs over 42 and a half wins this year. If they do that and they look even better like they did last season, where they were a four seed for a while in the Eastern Conference, LeBron's going to look around and go, okay, here's the deal. I can finish my career in Cleveland. You have potential defensive player of the year in Evan Mobley there, not to mention all of the other young talent, Darius Garland, everybody that they've built. I can go play there, play on a minimum salary. He didn't care. LeBron's got all the money in the world. I'll come back. I'll play on a minimum salary. I'll finish my career there. But you have to make sure that I get to play with my son, Bronny. You draft him. You tell other teams not to draft him. I don't care if it's the second round. It's LeBron and Bronny by 2024 in Cleveland with the Cavaliers. That, my friends, is how this all comes together. This is how it comes
Nick,
together right here.
since you have the tinfoil hat on, I might as well just go ahead and ask you, do you think we really landed on the moon?
Well, so there's a studio out in Hollywood that looks just like the moon. And I did my own research, Jenks, and I looked across the internet, and Google has told me that it may not be true. So I'm working on that. I'm trying to figure it out. We may be in a simulation. I'm not sure, but I think that we are in a
We
simulation right
are.
now.
We
If you look
are.
around,
No question.
the Matrix was actually a warning to let us know that we are in a simulation. So, LeBron James, the next part of his simulation is he's going back to Cleveland and he's going to play with Bronny. Ooh, I need some.
Oh my God. Famous last words.
You
I did my
started
own
this.
research. Well, I didn't think it was going to go down the hatch to did we actually land on the moon?
That's
But one
Jinx's
final
fault.
one
So,
before you go, just to, put in a little sports betting into this mix. So, conspiracy theory. Do you think that there is any chance that the Washington Commanders actually win their division?
I honestly, here, we're gonna get serious on that. My hair's all messed up. There is a chance because do you count on the Cowboys every single year? No, I don't care that they won 12 and 5. Mike McCarthy has the second best odds to be the first coach fired this year. Would you be surprised if Dallas started off poorly? No, it's not out of the realm of possibility. You can look at their schedule. You can look at the Eagles and say, sure, they improved, but who's Jalen Hurts? Is Jalen Hurts going to be a better quarterback this year? Can Carson Wentz early in the season look like a respectable quarterback? Can they at least win, let's say, 9 games, 9-8? 7-9 has won that division before in the past. There's always a possibility because nothing makes sense in the NFC East. Are the Cowboys still the best bet? Probably because they're the most talented. But at the same time, they regressed in the offseason. They didn't make a ton of additions while Philadelphia did. So I would probably still look at Philadelphia as the best team in the or not the best, as the best bet to win the NFC East. But I would not throw out Washington because nothing makes sense in that division ever, and it's always weird. And we are in a simulation,
Yes, we are.
and the Washington Commanders are destined for greatness, guys, as you can see with my tinfoil hat back on now. And Juan Soto's foot. Remember this. Here, this will just be just you guys can just put this all over social media. This will work fine.